factor verification. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to describe what multiplexing and demultiplexing are and how they work. You'll be able to identify the differences between TCP and UDP, explain the three-way handshake, and understand how TCP flags are used in this process. The basics of how firewalls keep networks safe. The transport layer
response gets received.
of 1 and an acknowledgement number of 2 could be read as, this is segment 1, expect segment 2 next. The data offset field comes next. This field is a 4-bit number that communicates how long the TCP header for this segment is. This is so that the receiving network device understands where the actual data payload begins. Then, we have 6 bits that are reserved for the 6 TCP control flags. The next field is a 16-bit number known as the TCP window. A TCP window specifies the range of sequence numbers that might be sent before an acknowledgement is required. TCP is a protocol that's super reliant on acknowledgements. This is done in order to make sure that all expected data is actually being received and that the sending device doesn't waste time sending data that isn't being received. The next field is a 16-bit checksum. It operates just like the checksum fields at the IP and Ethernet level. Once all of a segment has been ingested by a recipient, the checksum is calculated across the entire segment and is compared with the checksum in the header to make sure that there was no data lost or corrupted along the way. The urgent pointer field is used in conjunction with one of the TCP control flags to point out particular segments that might be more important than others. This is a feature of TCP that hasn't really ever seen adoption, and you'll probably never find it in modern networking. Even so, it's important to know what all sections of the TCP header are. Next up, we have the options field. Like the urgent pointer field, this is rarely used in the real world, but it's sometimes used for more complicated flow control protocols. Finally, we have some padding, which is just a sequence of zeros to ensure that the data payload section begins at the expected location. As a protocol, TCP establishes connections used to send long chains of segments of data. You can contrast this with the protocols that are lower in the networking model. These include IP and Ethernet, which just send individual packets of data. As an IT support specialist, you need to understand exactly how that works so you can troubleshoot issues where network traffic support specialists, may not be behaving in the expected manner. The way TCP establishes a connection is through the use of different TCP control flags used in a very specific order. Before we cover how connections are established and closed, let's first define the 6 TCP control flags. We'll look at them in the order that they appear in a TCP header. Heads up, this isn't necessarily in the same order of how frequently they're set or how important they are. The first flag is known as URG. This is short for urgent. A value of 1 here indicates that the segment is considered urgent and that the urgent pointer field has more data about this. This feature of TCP has never really had widespread adoption and isn't normally seen. The second flag is ACK, short for acknowledge. A value of 1 in this field means that the acknowledgement number field should be examined. The third flag is PSH, which is short for push. This means that the transmitting device wants the receiving device to push currently buffered data to the application on the receiving end as soon as possible. A buffer is a computing technique where a certain amount of data is held somewhere before being sent somewhere else. This has lots of practical applications. In terms of TCP, it's used to send large chunks of data more efficiently. By keeping some amount of data in a buffer, TCP can deliver more meaningful chunks of data to the program waiting for it. But in some cases, you might be sending a very small amount of information that you need the listening program to respond to immediately. This is what the push flag does. The fourth flag is RST, short for reset. This means that one of the sides in a TCP connection hasn't been able to properly recover from a series of missing or malformed segments. It's a way for one of the partners say, wait, I can't put together what you mean. Let's start over from scratch. The fifth flag is SYN, which stands for synchronize. It's used when first establishing a TCP connection and make sure the receiving end knows to examine the sequence number field. And finally, our sixth flag is FIN, which is short for finish. When this flag is set to 1, it means the transmitting computer doesn't have any more data to send and the connection can be closed. For a good example of how TCP control flags are used, let's check out how a TCP connection is established. Computer A will be our transmitting computer, and computer B will be our receiving computer. To start the process off, computer A sends a TCP segment to computer B with a SYN flag sent. This is computer A's way of saying, let's establish a connection and look at my sequence number field so we know where this conversation starts. Computer B then responds with a TCP segment where both the SYN and ACK flags are set. This is computer B's way of saying, sure, let's establish a connection and I acknowledge your sequence number. Then computer A responds again with just the ACK flag set, which is just saying, I acknowledge your acknowledgement. Let's start sending data. I love how polite they are to each other. This exchange involving segments that have SYN, SYN-ACK, and ACK set happens every single time a TCP connection is established anywhere and is so famous that it has a nickname, the three-way handshake. A handshake is a way for two devices to ensure that they're speaking the same protocol and will be able to understand each other. Once the three-way handshake is complete, the TCP connection is established. Now, computer A is free to send whatever data it wants to computer B and vice versa. Since both sides have now sent SYN-ACK pairs to each other, a TCP connection in this state is operating in full duplex. Each segment sent in either direction should be responded to by a TCP segment with the ACK field set. This way, the other side always knows what has been received. Once one of the devices involved with the TCP connection is ready to close the connection, something known as a four-way handshake happens. The computer ready to close the connection sends a FIN flag, which the other computer acknowledges with an ACK flag. Then, if this computer is also ready to close the connection, which will almost always be the case, it will send a FIN flag. This is again responded to by an ACK flag. Hypothetically, a TCP connection can stay open in simplex mode with only one side closing the connection, but this isn't something you'll run into very often. A socket is the instantiation of an endpoint in a potential TCP connection. An instantiation is the actual implementation of something defined elsewhere. TCP sockets require actual programs to instantiate them. You can contrast this with a port, which is more of a virtual descriptive thing. In other words, you can send traffic to any port you want, but you're only going to get a response if a program has opened a socket on that port. TCP sockets can exist in lots of states, and being able to understand what those mean will help you troubleshoot network connectivity issues as an IT support specialist. We'll cover the most common ones here. Listen. TCP sockets can exist in lots of states, and being able to understand what those mean will help you troubleshoot network connectivity issues as an IT support specialist. We'll cover the most common ones here. Listen. Listen means that a TCP socket is ready and listening for incoming connections. You'd see this on the server side only. SYN sent. This means that a synchronization request has been sent, but the connection hasn't been established yet. You'd see this on the client side only. SYN received. This means that a socket previously in a listen state has received a synchronization request and sent a SYN ACK back, but it hasn't received the final ACK from the client yet. You'd see this on the server side only. Established. This means that the TCP connection is in working order and both sides are free to send each other data. You'd see this state on both the client and server sides of a connection. This will be true of all the following socket states too, so keep that in mind. FIN wait. This means that a FIN has been sent, but the corresponding ACK from the other end hasn't been received yet. Close wait. This means that the connection has been closed at the TCP layer, but that the application that opened the socket hasn't released its hold on the socket yet. Closed. This means that the connection has been fully terminated and that no further communication is possible. There are other TCP socket states that exist. Additionally, socket states and their names can vary from operating system to operating system. That's because they exist outside of the scope of the definition of TCP itself. TCP, as a protocol, is universal in how it